Hey guys, it's been an interesting day to say the least. I was at Proton's Tanjung Malim factory earlier today for the media preview of one of the most anticipated Proton cars this year. I'm talking about the car maker's second SUV, the Proton X50. Yes, the Proton X70's little brother. And yes, the name is official. Hey, if you're a subscriber, welcome back. And if you're not, do click on the subscribe and bell icon. So here's all the details you need to know about the Proton X50. As you may know, the Proton X50 is based on the Geely Binyue. Did I pronounce it right? A great looking subcompact SUV that's also known as Cool Ray in the Philippines. The X50 is assembled at the Tanjung Malim plant, and according to Proton execs today, the car contains over 40% of local content. This is not limited to the complex left-hand drive to right-hand drive conversion. Proton also injected its talents in the design department. The result, a handsome looking car. In my opinion, even better and more contemporary looking than the X70. The aggressive sporty front showcases Proton's new corporate face and the new Thundercat logo. The front grille features the infinite weave, as Proton calls it, along with a hunting bow shaped frame. Notice the aggressive LED front headlamps. Overall, I'm digging this look, don't you? The side profile remains almost unchanged from the Binyue, but honestly, nothing to complain about. It has sporty sweeping lines and you'll even find 18-inch multi-spoke dual-tone alloy rims. This is on the range-topping flagship model, of course. More about the different models in a bit. Over on the back, the Proton script is flanked by a rear LED lamp cluster. Quite BMW inspired in my opinion. At the bottom is where it gets interesting. Quad exhaust pipes and a carbon fiber rear diffuser. It's worth noting that the quad exhaust is properly linked and not fake tips as found on some marquees. If you're impressed so far as I have on the exterior, then you'll be as pleased if not more about the interior. Overlaid with grey, red, silver and black tones, the cabin looks and feels great. If I must say, a step up from the X70, which is pretty polished and well put together in the first place. On that note, trim levels are certainly impressive. I must say I'm not too big a fan of the race-inspired D-shaped steering, but it does offer a good diameter and feel. I do, however, like the sculptured dash and especially the fighter aircraft-like side aircon vents. The center console in silver finish houses the gear shifter lifted from the X70 and various buttons for the e-brake, driving modes, and even autonomous parking. Yes, my Malaysian friends, auto parking. The flagship model packs a 10-inch touchscreen infotainment system powered by GKUI 19, the latest version debuting on the X50. GKUI 19 boasts a host of enhancements, including a new UI and user experience, and even replaces the dreaded Baidu Maps. What's important is the entire system is quicker and more responsive. In case you're wondering, it still lacks Android Auto and Apple CarPlay support. The driver's side seat with electric controls offer plenty of support and I found rear leg and headroom quite impressive, even for my 6-foot frame. It offers over 330 liters of boot space with completely fold-down rear seats for more storage. Okay, I've rambled a little bit more than I expected for this preview video, but here's what's important. The X50 comes in four variants. The 1.5T Standard, 1.5T Executive, 1.5T Premium, and 1.5T GDI Flagship. It's the first time I've heard a flagship anything actually being called flagship in its name. Interesting, Proton. Anyway, what's unexpected is the existence of two engine options. The range-topping 1.5T GDI Flagship model is powered by the 1.5-liter three-cylinder direct injection turbo gasoline engine that pushes 175 horsepower, 177 PS, and 255 newton meters of torque. This is mated to the same 7-speed wet dual clutch transmission found on the X70. This is enough to pull the X50 from zero to hero in 8.6 seconds. Not shabby. The rest of the variants get a lower-powered 3-cylinder gasoline engine. There have been various power output numbers quoted by the media, ranging from 140 horsepower to 150 horsepower. My attempts to get official numbers from Proton product execs have been futile. I've even been quoted 130 bhp. But, you know, we'll know soon enough. Meanwhile, torque is 226 Nm. The flagship model, of course, gets all the bells and whistles, including a panoramic sunroof, upgraded advanced drive assistance system or ADAS 2.0, and much more. ADAS encapsulates an impressive array of active safety features, including blind spot information system, lane departure warning, forward collision warning, autonomous emergency braking, intelligent high beam control, and adaptive cruise control. Let's not forget the 6 SRS airbags and a 5-star ASEAN NCAP rating. The X50 will offer 6 exterior color options, including snow white, jet gray, armor silver, ocean blue, citric orange, and passion red. And to wrap up, Proton is opening the X50 for booking starting Malaysia Day, 16 September. You can place a booking with just a 500 ringgit booking fee. Expect to see a city preview of the car starting 19th of September, 2020. Unfortunately, no pricing details have been revealed at this time. So how much do you think the X50 will be priced at? I'm guessing the entry level starting at around 7,000 ringgit and topping 90,000 or so for the flagship. This will give it a 20 to 30,000 pricing advantage over its rival. For reference, the X70 starts at around 95,000 ringgit and tops 123,000 ringgit. But we'll see, won't we? So that's it guys, I hope you enjoyed the video and found it useful. If you did, give me a big thumbs up. Do let me know what you think about Proton's latest SUV in the comments below. Hit subscribe and the bell icon. And to all Malaysians all around the world, Selamat Hari Malaysia. Take care, stay safe, and peace.